Righto, we're going to have a couple more company presentations before we get to the lunch break, and we're delighted to welcome Victor Cantori, who's on the advisory board of Infinit Lithium, who is going to tell you about their projects. So, Victor.
So, this goes... Well, thanks for attending the presentation. So my name is Victor Cantori. I'm on the advisory board of Infinit Lithium. Myself, my background, I was the vendor who sold the property to Nemaska Lithium back in 2009. So Nemaska's that's where my inroad started with the lithium space. So this project is a brand new project that we just started recently drilling. And why are we talking about lithium? I mean, when we just look at lithium and what's going on in the lithium space, you've got Volkswagen spending over $40 billion by 2022. You've got BMW with 50 new launches. You've got Ford. I mean, we all heard all these claims. So we continued progressing. And when you look at this chart, for example. When you look at these numbers on the lithium hydroxide side, now when you're talking about batteries, when you're looking at an NCA battery, it's a nickel cobalt manganese battery. Anytime you start bringing more nickel into it, you need hydroxide. That's why the numbers on the hydroxide, when you look at the CAGR on hydroxide, you're looking at 38.8%. You're still going to be needing a carbonate over the years, but the growth is really, and even when you take the numbers on the low side, those are quite large numbers. In 2017, the production of lithium carbon equivalent, you're looking at a little over 200,000 tons. By 2031, you're looking at 1.58 million tons on the low side. So we really think that the thesis on lithium is still alive and well and going forward. This project that we have, it's a hard rock project, and currently, when you still look at the prices, although I'm sure everybody's heard about Morgan Stanley with their assumptions that prices were going to fall, prices are still very firm. You're looking at a U.S. $16,500 a ton. These are sales prices outside of China. So an FOB in North America for lithium hydroxide and for carbon is still a $14,500 a ton. Which puts many projects still very, very profitable. When we look at the project highlights, we have about 2.56 square kilometers. It's where Infinit Lithium is. That's where the main discovery is. We're currently drilling one of the exceptional drill cores that we got 5 meters at 3.02%. And 7.23 meters at 2.47%. I mean, these are numbers that outside of Greenbushes just doesn't exist. Why we started this project? We had a historic resource of 2 million tons at 1.09%. So we figured it was a good place to start with a historic resource. This was Cominco that drilled this back in the 60s. Now, when we advance this thing a bit forward. Currently, we're drilling. Well, I'll give you the drilling right after that. Now, where is the property located? It's well located. It's about 12 kilometers away from the Trans-Canada Highway, Highway 11. That's one of the main highways there. There's a railroad. You can just drive right up to the property. Now, if we go over through some of these results, so we drilled a total of 15 holes. We did 2,052 meters. We're just going to continue drilling with the grades that we got. They're quite exceptional. So I mean, when you look at 1.09%, and you look at all the Li2O grades that we have over here, you can definitely tell that the results are going to come in well above 1.09%. We have more results over here. One of the exceptional results that we got. We ended up drilling deeper. The hole J1813, where we ended up getting again 5 meters at 3.02%, which is really exceptional. It's outside of Greenbushes. These results really don't exist. So what we're going to be continue doing here, we're going to continue to the next phase drill program. We're going to continue to build tonnage and then continue to increase the grade. So the next thing that we're going to end up doing is we're going to put out our 43-101 compliant resource. We're not just going to confirm the 2 million tons with the grades that we have right now and the strike lengths. We know we've more than achieved that. We want to take this straight to a world class deposit. We want to take this thing to 10 to 15 million tons initially. Do the economic studies at that point. Metallurgy is also going to be starting shortly. We're going to be sending it out to SGS to produce a concentrate, at least a 6% concentrate. And from that concentrate, we'll end up always at lab. We'll end up doing producing a carbonate and a high hydroxide, obviously with a high purity. And from there, we're going to lead it to a feasibility study. We really want to move this on a fast track. We're hoping to get our first economic study, the PA, by the end of this year. This is the capital structure of the company. There's 58 million shares right now outstanding. There's 46 million warrants that are good for 2 years. They're at 20 cents. The stock presently is trading around the 15 cent range, 14, 15 cents. It's a $8 million market cap. There's about $4 million in the bank. Approximately $8 million will come in from the warrants over time. So we don't feel we need to go to the market for financing anytime soon. We already have institutions that are involved. Some of the same institutions that are in some of our other projects. And that's it for the presentation. If you guys have any questions, we've got a couple of minutes. If not, it's fine. Good. All right, guys.